Thousands of visitors a year find this the perfect place to pass a lazy, hazy summer day. You can take a stroll, check out the cute little cottages, or grab something to eat.
But that's a great place to hang out at night, too. You just go in there and sit and have a cup of coffee.
Welcome to Lilydale, a lovely Casadega lakeside community that has been called the town that talks with the dead.
If I was a spirit, I would rather stay, I'd just stay here and be ornery.
That's Ron Nagy, Lilydale historian, author, and a guy who can teach you how to bend a spoon with your mind. More on that later. Ron enjoys telling folks how this all began.
In 1900, there was 300 houses in here.
Lilydale, the town that spiritualism built. Spiritualism, a religion based on the idea that you can communicate with those who have passed on, with the help of a medium. So popular was spiritualism in the late 1800s, they boasted 8 million followers in the United States. These days, Lilydale has 300 full-time residents, and about half stay here year-round.
Right, Tom?
What's that?
You and your wife are here year-round.
That's right.
One of the hot spots here is the museum. This is where Ron gives his spoon bending workshop.
Yeah. I'm not going to bend it.
Oh, you're not?
No.
You can't.
But I get you in a mood, and this thing will just almost melt in your hands.
You'll have to sign up for that workshop, Bridge.
The only thing I know how to do with a spoon, other than eat or serve, is, you know, and then hang on the nose. That's about all I got.
The museum features piles of old pictures, news clippings, and some interesting apparatus like this spiritualist trumpet.
They used to take these to seances and say you sit around in a circle in your living room on your chairs, or you could use a table, or you could lay that down, or you could stand that up, but sometimes they move.
Speaking of moving, Ron says during one of his tours, this bookcase came off the floor.
And then it comes back down, but it didn't slam down. It like floated down and just nothing broken, nothing moved in there. You can see the dirt lines around the floor. Mm-hmm. And everybody's in here like boogie-eyed and like, whoa.
And if you think that's strange, check this out.
There was a lady in, her name was Lee Hall. She's passed away now. She was a medium in Jamestown, and she used to draw your past lifetimes, the ones that were affecting you now.
Ron wrote the book on spirit painting, literally.
And that sells pretty good here.
You can spend hours milling through the museum, and many do, but it's time to call up a few spirits. We check in with resident medium Kitty Osborne, and since I had no dearly departed I needed to chat with, Bridget volunteered for the job.
So I want to talk a little bit about your health, wealth, self-image, your projection into the future.
Kitty told Bridget she had a nice aura.
There's a little static electricity there. That means your energy is good.
Needed to start saving her change in a jar.
And the availability of money will be there for you, so feed that jar.
And was going to buy new shoes.
Did you get them last week?
Mm-mm.
You're getting them.
That's nice, but what about the spirits?
You should be eating more fruits and veggies, and you probably don't have time to, but you need to do that, okay?
And then fruits I want you all
it's
to
true.
Drink
the water, honey.
I never drink water.
You have
She's
to.
So right.
Drink water, eat vegetables. Finally, we get to the spirits.
You know who that is?
My grandfather, had emphysema.
And he's giving me kind of like a bowl of, it's ectoplasm is what it is, but it looks like cotton candy.
Cotton candy? Now I'm getting hungry. Not sure how Kitty scored with Bridget's reading, but you don't have to be a medium to figure out Lilydale is a fun place to spend the day.